You know, yeah, you're supposed to say like watermelon, watermelon, and oh, welcome to Microsoft Unboxed. But yeah, let's keep talking because I think we're more important. Yeah. My name is Sonia Dara, and I'm joined by one of my friends and co-hosts, Colleen O'Brien.
Hello, world.
Every week, we're going to share stories from Microsoft about great technology, and we're going to talk about the great people behind that technology. And today's theme is
security.
We're gonna make it fun.
Let's go.
But before we get to that, don't forget to subscribe, hit that button right down there, and let's get rolling.
Security blankets.
You got any?
I think my like year-round security blanket might be something more like a quesadilla.
Like a quesadilla, such, the food?
Yeah, I'm not like snuggling up under a quesadilla.
I've seen blankets though that look like burritos. Like they look like, and so you snuggle in a burrito, but you mean legitimately the food.
Yeah,
I love quesadillas.
I literally like to eat a quesadilla.
It's so weird.
All right, well, I'll ask you a different question then so you don't get embarrassed here.
Nothing can beat quesadillas, so it's a lose-lose.
What's your favorite bank heist movie?
I really liked Italian Job.
Ooh, what did you like about it?
Key characters and players, and I like Charlize Theron, and she was the smart one who knew how to crack into a safe. And then there's Mini Coopers, which I always wanted when it came out. My dad was like, Sonia, you won't fit into one. Why are you trying to buy one? Like, my head would have had to stick out the, like, top of the car. It's too small.
I wait for a moment where you're gonna take a breath to, like, interject, and you're like, I'm gonna say this now instead.
We love talking about cloud.
You literally can't shut us up about it.
We're always talking about it because it's that important. We are responsible for housing a lot of storage on behalf of multiple companies and governments. Because we are housing all this data, a lot of people are actually trying to attack us to get said data. Cloud computing operations detects 1.5 million attacks and attempts a day.
1.5 million?
Yeah, our system is so intelligent that it's not just fending off these attacks, it's also learning at the same time and feeding it into our company's intelligent security graph. So imagine there's one type of phishing attack that happens on one set of cloud platform services. We'll apply whatever we've learned to defend that attack and apply it across all of our services.
Effectively scaling your insights.
Exactly. Every time someone tries attacking us, we're actually getting smarter. A lot of people might think that keeping their data on a hard drive physically is the best way because they know where it is. But then each individual is responsible for defending and protecting their data as opposed to having Microsoft be that sole job of protecting your data across multiple areas, right? So you might have multiple hard drives and multiple systems that you're doing, whether it's your payroll sitting over here on this server and you have anything about social security numbers for your employees there. Like, we would protect it opposed to you having to see all these different endpoints and trying to protect it. The other great thing is we have built our cloud infrastructure from the ground up with modern security and privacy built in.
The bones of our solution.
Yeah, we wouldn't exist without it. Microsoft scans 400 billion emails for malware and phishing scams each month, and we invest over $1 billion every year in cloud security. So we mean business. We have over 3,500 security engineers dedicated to this, fine-tuning approaches, learning from cyber attacks, learning from some of these that were false negatives and false positives. What gets flagged out of 1,000 attacks, say 999 of them are falsely positive, but one is, and then the other way around where it's falsely negative and something's actually come through, we learn a lot from that and like what qualified that to actually get through our system.
So those are fairly small numbers, but the stakes are really high.
Especially for a false negative. One thing that Microsoft wanted to try to land, especially outside of just corporations, but for governments, is that we need to establish a standard for international like conduct and how we're thinking about protecting people's privacy when it comes to government relations. So we know that the technology around security and privacy is advancing very quickly, but almost faster than public policy. So our president, Brad Smith, proposed the first ever digital Geneva Convention, where we can actually establish these standards to protect people's privacies and data.
I don't have to worry about all of my family photos getting stolen.
Or your cat photos, maybe.
I'm like so allergic to cats, I don't even like to joke about having cat photos. Well, you mentioned some of the teams who are working on security here at Microsoft, and I'm actually going to tell a story about one specific team. They are the Red Team.
Oh, yeah, Red Team. I remember this. That's cool.
Cool. So the Red Team is an elite Microsoft hacker team that is keeping Windows PCs safe. So Windows still boasts nearly 90% of market share for laptop and desktop computers worldwide. So it's really important that we're keeping all of these PCs safe.
Yeah, and surfaces.
David Weston is a partner group manager focused on security here at Microsoft. He was a little frustrated with our approach to security.
It sounds like he was frustrated.
Typically, they were waiting for a big attack to happen, and then the team would spend time trying to fix it.
Reactively.
Exactly.
Okay. And he wanted to get proactive.
That is correct.
Yes, I like his style.
So David gets aggressive and puts together a team that's going to focus on hacking Windows every single day.
Oh, that's cool.
That's correct. This team is really comprised of amazing and elite hackers, one of whom jailbroke Nintendo handhelds in a former life, another who can claim more than one zero-day exploit. All of these people are world-class hackers. They're working on everything from browser security to tackling kernel and virtualization issues. Some of them are actually working on things that are so sensitive that I can't tell you about them.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah. Imagine if your job was to come in every day and break stuff. It sort of reminds me of when you did a little demo over at Building One.
When I literally broke Building One. It was awesome.
One of the most interesting things about them is that they time themselves on their hacks.
Oh.
And that gives them an objective performance indicator. They then put a price tag on that amount of time. Their goal is to drive that number up. They want to make hacking Windows as costly as possible to dissuade any potential hackers from wanting to do it. So when Weston, the leader of this team, is particularly impressed with a hack that his team has performed, he distributes computer-shaped trophies. Isn't that nice?
That's nice. That's a good.
Yeah, I want to go to like one of their award ceremonies. Great hack. Because Windows is 90% of laptop and desktop computers worldwide, I'm feeling a little safer here with the Red Team on our team.
Me too. Good job, Red Team. Keeping us safe.
We'll give you a computer trophy.
I can give you 2 thumbs up right now.
How about 4?
Speaking of breaking into things, we're gonna break into our box for Outside the Box.
Yay!
Transition lines. Would you rather be invisible or read minds?
Oh my gosh, I would rather be invisible. Can you imagine how awful it would be to read everyone's mind?
I would only want to read minds if I could communicate back with them, like Professor X.
And am I invisible all the time? Or
I don't know, you can qualify however you want.
Okay, I have the ability to become invisible.
Yeah,
yep. I think I'm invisible. That's what I want. Have you ever met a celebrity?
Yes.
Question answered.
The coolest run-in with celebrities was at Comic-Con, and we got to go for this party, and we were thinking it was just like the other sponsors who were there. No, it was like the cast of Game of Thrones, the cast of Walking Dead.
What?
Yeah, the Internet Explorer team was there, and we had so much fun. And I was standing in line to get a drink, and I feel someone very tall and big behind me, and I turn around, and it's the Hound from Game of Thrones, and I'm like, oh my goodness. And he was like, hello. And someone hands him a shot. He takes a shot and goes, oh, that was disgusting. I was like, yeah, you know, it's kind of sweet, kind of, you know, girly. And he was like, I need a manly drink. You know what's manly? Reaches into his shirt, pulls out a tuft of chest hair, holds it right in my face and goes, this is manly. And then walks away. And I was just left there like, what just happened? Sorry, I went way over 30 seconds.
That's gonna wrap this show forever.
Thanks for joining us for this week's episode. If you have any great questions to add to the box, make sure you submit them to the email address below or comment on this video. And if you're the Hound, remember me.
And don't forget to subscribe. Just hit the button right now.
Right now.
There it is.
Right now. Just click it. You have to do the thumbs up!
Hey everyone, if you can't get enough of us, I would highly recommend subscribing to our podcast, Women in Business and Technology, available right here.
And you can follow us on Twitter and Instagram at our social handles right here.